Welcome to another video on verifying trigonometric identities. This video will focus on the sum, difference, double, and half angle identities. So here's a list of all the identities that we'll be working with in this video. One of the most challenging parts about verifying identities using these is deciding which one to use. And so sometimes it does take a lot of practice to get good at verifying identities. So hopefully you'll keep a positive attitude and stick with it. So let's go ahead and get started. We have a choice here to either use the double angle identity or we could multiply this out on the left. I'm going to go ahead and multiply the left side out. So we'll FOIL this. When we multiply this out, we'll have sine a times sine a, or sine squared a. Next, we'll have a sine a times cosine a. And then we have a cosine a times sine a. So we have two like terms. So we'll have plus 2 sine a cosine a plus cosine squared a. The next thing we should notice is that sine squared a plus cosine squared a is equal to 1. So we'll have 2 sine a cosine a plus 1 equals sine 2a plus 1. And now, believe it or not, we have it. Remember, the identity sine 2a is equal to 2 sine a cosine a, so we can replace this with sine of 2a. So it is important that you are pretty comfortable with these identities because it will help you recognize when to perform the correct substitutions. Let's go ahead and try another. Here on the right, there's not much we can do with cosine x minus sine x, but notice on the left, we have cosine of x plus pi over 4. We can expand this using the sum identity for cosine. So the left side can be rewritten as the cosine of a times cosine b. So the cosine of x times cosine of pi over 4. Since we have a sum, we'll use a difference on the left. Sine a or sine x times sine b or sine pi over 4. Next, we can evaluate cosine pi over 4 and sine pi over 4. And if you don't have your unit circle handy, the sine of pi over 4 and the cosine of pi over 4 are both equal to the square root of 2 over 2. And now we're making very good progress. You can see that they're almost the same now. Both of these terms have a common factor of square root 2 over 2, so we can factor that out. And I believe they're going to match now. And they do, so we're done. And let's go ahead and take a look at one more. Now this problem can look intimidating, especially if you're not familiar with your identities. So it is important that you have a good list of them and you know how to use them. And on this problem, I'm going to work from both sides. So I can replace sine of 2a with 2 sine a cosine a. And on the right side, I'm going to use the half angle identities. Notice that this is cosine squared a over 2, so that's going to eliminate the square root here. So cosine squared a over 2 is going to equal 1 plus cosine a over 2. Again, since this is squared, it's undoing that square root, minus sine squared a over 2. We'll have 1 minus cosine a over 2. Next, on the left side, we have a common factor of 2 as well as sine a. So on the left, we're left with cosine a. Now on the right, notice we have a common denominator, so let's go ahead and add these fractions. Now we do have to be careful when we do this. We're subtracting this entire quantity. So let's put our parentheses in place. Denominator is 2. Next, we have 1 minus 1, that's 0. And then we have cosine a minus a negative cosine a. So that'll give us 2 cosine a. And believe it or not, in just a couple of quick steps, we have verified this identity. These two simplify nicely. And so we have cosine a equals cosine a. Again, because I provided the correct identities for each of these problems, it may seem a lot easier than when you open a textbook and start working some problems. So you just have to be patient with it and try different things and become familiar with those identities. Again, thank you for watching and have a good day.